United States of America, United Arab Emirates, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and Uganda. He has also served with World Bank on Road Safety Project in Pakistan as the Executive Director, and he has also served as the Executive Director of National Road Safety Secretariat of Pakistan and successfully led the development of first ever National Road Safety Plan of Pakistan. While in US, he has successfully managed the Road Safety Program of New York City for over 7 years. He has also served as the Regional Traffic Control and Operation Engineer for Long Island region of New York State, encompassing 3,000 square miles of area with 3 million people and 700 miles of highways. He has also served as a Regional Transport Planning Manager for New York Metro Area and a co-chair of New York Metropolitan Transportation Safety Advisory Group. This group is comprised of state and local government transportation agencies was responsible for setting safety goals and guiding principles for safety policies and regulation and ensuring safety is incorporated into transportation planning process. In Middle East, he served as a manager highway management, policy and strategic planning. For Abu Dhabi, Department of Transport, led traffic safety specialist for Qatar Ministry of Municipality and Urban Planning and Road and Traffic Engineering Expert on Makkah Public Transport System. Presently, he is providing consulting services to NHA in area of road safety. Mr. Amel holds a master's degree in transportation planning from City University of New York. In addition, he has completed over 500 hours of formal training in areas of transportation planning, traffic engineering and road safety, mostly in USA. He was awarded the Excellence in Engineering Award by New York State for his outstanding and distinguished contribution to the state of New York. In addition to his knowledge and experience in road safety, Azad brings his passion for saving humanity lives being lost due to road crashes, which makes him a true road safety professional. Without further ado, I hand over the floor to Mr. Azad Ahmed.
Well, we are setting up one of my introduction is I am a former executive director of National Road Safety Academy. One of the accomplishments of National Road Safety Secretariat, which worked from 2006 to 2007, is that that secretariat developed Pakistan's first ever National Road Safety Plan. And that plan was due to officially launched on September 11, 2007. And the Highway Safety Council meeting was all scheduled and set. But unfortunately, the federal minister of that time canceled that meeting one day before the meeting. So the plan still exists, but it was not officially adopted because the meeting was canceled. And I invite those who are working to get benefit of that plan. That plan was for the whole Pakistan, not just for national highways, and much more comprehensive document covering all aspects. Engineering, enforcement, and legislation, which is very important. There is a whole chapter on legislation review needs and what we need to do and specific recommendations in that regard. Today, as today's topic is Safer Road, Safer Pakistan, we will see that how the road engineering can play its role. Because safer road starts with a safer road design. And unfortunately, we lack in this area. So in today's presentation, through the photographs and some small 30 seconds videos, I will show you what are the road safety engineering and design issues we have, and we have it for the last 50 and 60 years, and unfortunately our design consultants still continue to design the same mistakes in their current design. And I hope particularly those students, civil engineering students here, and they may pursue their career in highway design or in transportation, so they will not be making these mistakes. And I would invite our motorway police that if they see these issues in any of the highways, notify the concerned highway authority, whether it's NHA, whether it's provincial highway authority, or a local highway authority like CDA. Can everybody hear me clearly?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Is the slides again transferred?
Yes.
So today's agenda, we basically show you some of the widely observed road safety design issues in Pakistan. And we'll not only show you the issues, we will also show you what are the safety implications. If we design this feature, would we design this way, what will happen? And then we'll also show you the remedy. What are the best international practices in the world? How we should be designing our highways. One of the common problems you will see in our highways, and particularly in the hilly and mountain area, is very sharp curves. And most of these photographs is of our own highway system. Some of the photographs is not from Pakistan, which I will mention. But most of the photographs I will be showing you is from our highway. So you can see this sharp horizontal curve, the S curve. We not only design sharp curves, but we also design S curves, which is, you can see, that two curves in opposite direction, which makes the problem more complicated. And what happens is this, you see in this photograph, this white little car is in the wrong lane because of this curve. And why he's doing it, he was not able to see the oncoming traffic, so he drifted towards right, so he could see, and put him in the danger of head-on collision. And why all this happened? Because our designers did not take care of the side distance issue. Civil engineers are here? Mm-hmm. Raise your hand, who are the civil engineers? Side distance is very important. He is drifting towards right, so he could see the oncoming car. It's like the photograph that I took it myself. And you see, implication. This did not happen on that day, but this could have happened on that day. See, head on collision. See, one more time. So, side distance is horizontal curve and vertical is a very important consideration of design, which sometimes ignores, unfortunately. Another thing is, design of a curve. At curve, the lane width needs to be increased. Those are engineers understand the off-traffic phenomena. And when turns, they need a wider area to turn because their rear wheel does not follow their front wheel. If the off-tracking is not taken into the design, this is the result. See that the truck, look where is the front wheel of the truck and see where are the rear wheels of the truck. This truck was not designed from the off-tracking standpoint, and this is the result. And then see vertical curve also restricts the side distance. See that here, this is also one of our national highways. And you can see that if you are here, you will not be able to see the region in the depression here. So, horizontal and vertical design is very important consideration. This is Islamabad. Anybody knows which highway is this? 7th Avenue, right. See that?
You cannot see the traffic coming from the other side. On mountain areas, sometimes we cannot improve the curvature. But if we take care of the warning duty, which we have our legal expert here, highway agencies have a duty to care. And if they cannot provide proper care, they must warn. They have a duty to warn of the danger. Is the duty of the warn has been fulfilled here? Probably not. This shows that, you know, when vehicle is lost from the site because of the horizontal and vertical traffic. Very important consideration. And, you know, sometimes they say, you know, why rain improves the curve? And the consequence is existing, we follow the existing alignment. But you are basically rehabilitating, reconstructing the old road. Why you have to take in the design problems, the existing alignment, to the reconstructed road? And they have no answer.